What's going on, my friends? This is Dustin Stelzer with Electrician U. Today, I'm going to answer a question that I had on Instagram, Zach Pilecki. He asked, "Hey, Dustin, I had a quick question. Can you help me understand something? Our class was reading up on Ohm's law, and our book was saying that voltage and amperage are directly proportional to each other, and resistance is inversely proportional to current. Does that mean if voltage increases, so will amperage? I just didn't know if I was translating it correctly." That's a really good question. So inversely proportional and directly proportional. Directly proportional means if you raise one value, the other one goes up directly with it. Inversely means if you raise one value, the other one's gonna go down. They're the inverse of each other. So let's look at that a little bit. So we've got our Ohm's law, right? So E equals I times R is Ohm's law. If we go back here, this is the wheel that we kind of use visually to not have to worry about the craziness of the math. It's not that crazy, but it helps people. If you're trying to solve for I, you know that your formula is going to be I equals E over R. You just hide the value. If you're trying to find resistance, you hide R and say R equals E over I. Same thing here. If you're trying to find voltage, you go E equals I times R. They're right across from each other. So another way to look at that is just this. I've rearranged all three of the equations. It's the same things I was just showing you. So E equals I times R, but I also equals E over R and R equals E over E. And if you don't know how to like do that, if that kind of blows your mind, like why, how the hell? If you, just in basic algebra, if we have E equals I times R, well, this is solving for E. So we need to know E, I and R. But if we don't have the values and we need to solve for amperage instead, all you do is divide by whichever value that you're not trying to find. So if we're trying to find I, we would divide by R to get rid of those R's and leave I isolated by itself. But in an equation, you have to balance the equation. So you always have to have whatever you do on the left, you gotta do on the right. So we would go E over R. So that leaves us with I equals E over R. Same thing, you know, we just do the inverse of it. But that's how the math actually works out. So if you're ever sitting there in a test or in a class and you're trying to figure out like, damn it, what was the formula? I know this one, but I don't know how to make it like that. Just remember that you're dividing by the value that you're trying to get rid of on both sides. So if we have a circuit and we know, we took our multimeter out and we tested the resistance of this certain resistor and we didn't want to turn current on, we wanted to know what kind of current we should expect. We know we have a 120 volt circuit, so we have our voltage. We know the resistance because we went to resistance on our multimeter and we actually tested the resistance here, so we know the resistance value. So the only thing we don't have is I, so this wouldn't be the right equation to use. It's just more difficult because then you gotta move everything around. So you wanna use this one. It leaves I by itself and you can use these two values. So you would use I equals E over R. We know E is 120. Oops, 120. And we know our resistance is 10 ohms. So zeros cancel out and we get 12 amps. So what does that tell us about the proportionality? It doesn't really, because we need to do another example to see by changing one of the values if anything changes. So we know that with 120 volts and a 10 amp resistor, we have 12 amps of current running through. So what happens if we double our voltage and we go to 240 volts? But we keep the resistance the same, just raising voltage to see what happens with current. So we have 240 volts, and we have a resistance of 10. Zeros cancel out, we get 24 amps. So our amperage has increased because our voltage has increased. So those two values are directly proportional. If you raise your voltage in one, the current flowing through the circuit is always going to be more if the resistance stays the same in both scenarios. So let's change a different value. Say we want to find our resistance and we don't know the resistance. We can't get into whatever we're doing to like actually measure any kind of resistance reading on it. But we do have our ammeter and we can clamp around it and see, oh, well at 240 volts, that's running, that's you know, potential across this resistance, it's drawing 5 amps. So we know these two values, but we don't know resistance. So we're gonna use this one because we wanna get the answer for that, and we already have those two values. So if we have 240 volts and 5 amps of current running through it, we would just do 240 divided by 5. That is 48 ohms of resistance. So in this situation, 48 ohms. Okay, so let's try to change something again. Let's change our current to see what it does to the resistance. So in this situation, still 240 volts, but we're gonna have 15 amps worth of current on the circuit now. So there's a lot more current flowing, which means there's less opposition to current. So it should go down. The resistance number should decrease. So we take 240 volts and divide that by 15, 16 ohms. So now we know our resistance has gone down, but our current has gone up. So current and resistance have an inversely proportional relationship. We found out that voltage and current have a directly proportional relationship. So what about voltage and resistance? So voltage and resistance, if we look at an equation, how an equation is laid out, you can tell really easy on the equation what values are gonna be in which proportionality to each other. I equals E over R. Because we have a value that's a numerator here, like basically I is the same thing as I over one. So this is always the numerator, this is always the denominator. Anytime you have a numerator that has a denominator on the other side, these two values are always going to be inverse of each other. And any values that are on the top side, the numerators are always gonna have a directly proportional relationship. So we have these two different equations. We have E equals, or I equals E over R. So I and R, because one is in the numerator and one is in the denominator, this and this are gonna have an inverse relationship to each other. They're not gonna be directly proportional. Same thing here and here. We just flip the signs really, you know. But that's the only thing in all of these equations that is inversely proportional. Everything else is in a numerator, so it is all directly proportional. So both, if you take the current, if you take, you know, the current amperage and the voltage and you increase one, you're gonna increase the other. Also, if you take voltage and you take resistance and you increase one of them or the other, it's going to increase both of them. So there's no denominator in any part of that equation. So hope that answers your question. Current and resistance in an electrical circuit are always gonna be inversely proportional. You raise one, one's gonna go down. Everything else is directly proportional.
Best music and video.